What was your reality on August 21st? What happened in your judgment?
We're not in the area where the alleged chemical attack was happened, as it alleged. We're not sure that anything had been caught.
Even at this date, you are not sure that chemical weapons, even though you have seen the videotape, even though you've seen the bodies, even though your own officials have been there.
I haven't finished. Our soldiers in another area were attacked chemically. Our soldiers, they went to the hospital as casualties because of chemical weapons. But in the area where they said the government used chemical weapons, we only had video and we only have pictures and allegations. We're not there. Our forces, our police, our institutions don't exist. How can you talk about what happened? We don't have evidences. We're not like the American administration. We're not social media administration or government. We are the government that deals with reality. Well, when we have evidences, we will announce.
Well, as you know, Secretary Kerry has said there is evidence that they saw rockets that fired from a region controlled by your forces into a region controlled by the rebels. They have evidence from satellite photographs of that. They have evidence of a message that was intercepted about chemical weapons, and that soon thereafter there were other intercepted messages. So Secretary Kerry has presented what he concludes is conclusive evidence.
No, he presented his confidence and he presented his convictions. It's not about confidence, it's about evidence. The Russians have completely opposite evidence that the missiles were thrown from area where the rebels controlled. That reminds me about what Kerry said, about the big lie that Colin Powell said in front of the world on satellites about the WMD in Iraq before going to war, when he said, this is our evidence. He gave false evidence. In this case, Kerry didn't even present any evidence. He talked, we have evidence, and he didn't present anything. Not yet, nothing so far.
With the United-
not single shred of evidence.
Kerry also asked Assad if he believes Washington will go ahead with military action against his country.
There is an intense discussion going on about all the things we're talking about in Washington, where if there's a strike, it will emanate from the United States' decision to do this. What do you want to say in this very important week in America and in Washington to the American people, to members of Congress, to the President of the United States?
I think the most important part of this now is, say, the American people, but the polls show that the majority now don't want a war anywhere, not only against Syria. But the Congress is going to vote about this in a few days, and I think the Congress is elected by the people and represent the people and work for their interests. The first question that they should ask themselves, what do wars give America since Vietnam till now? Nothing. No political gain, no economic gain, no good reputation. The United States is at all low time. The credibility is at all low, all time low. So this war is against the interests of the United States. Why? First of all, because this is the war that's going to support Al-Qaeda and the same people that kill Americans in the 11th of September. The second thing that we all want to tell to the Congress that they should ask, and that what